Are you ready for the killer? Yeah. Are you ready for the killer?
Absolutely.
Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan ik niet pikken. Dat kan ik niet pikken, de jeuk. Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan ik niet pikken. Dat kan ik niet pikken, de jeuk. Is geen klappetje door, dat ken ik goed verstand. Dan rijd elke serieuze mengs al eens beoefde aan. Maar kom maar niet vertellen dat je heel de dag lang klapt. Wees hoe ver je schep geeft door dat we mee aan het ogen. En was het alleen was losse en een beetje tijdig en rust. Of het ook liggen vossen, schat, hoe ver ging dat gemust? Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk?
So, what we have here is an assortment of big and medium-sized tilapia. So, what I'm doing now is to segregate.
It caught in your mouth, or
yeah, the slime, because that's where actually that's the thing that you should look out for if you want to look for fresh tilapia. If they're slimy, they're still fresh, because slime is the what they call this?
A sign of
their defense.
There's their defense. Yes.
Defense.
Because they're going to walk.
Yeah, but it's really scary to hold them really tight because their fins on top, or I don't know.
Yeah, they're like pins.
They're like big needles. So
yeah. When hold you on get the head. Yeah. Press on the head.
So
now he doesn't want to get in.
Yeah. See.
That's a really big one, you know.
Yeah.
That's more than a half kilo.
You can see here, like a big needle sticking out.
Mm-hmm.
If you get that in your skin,
it's nice.
It's going to hurt a lot.
It's like you get an injection, but it's more painful.
Yeah. Mm. So these are the.
Oh. You're already eating the slimy stuff. Oh. It's on your funny beard.
Yeah. It's going to.
Those are the small ones already.
These are medium size.
Medium,
so
yes. This is a very small one.
Yeah. No, it's not.
No.
Ah, okay.
Because when you eat the big ones, it's like good for three servings, yeah, 2 to 3 servings.
Right. Yes.
You cannot finish the entire fish at one sitting. But it depends again on the person. If it was me, I'm going to finish
in
two of those in one sitting.
Of course, but that's you.
Yeah.
That's not everybody is you.
Yeah. So we're going to put or mix them up.
Mm.
Because two clients ordered 3 kilos each.
Mm. So you mix them up so that they have both some small and some big.
Yeah. Which one? This one.
It's 2.5 kilo. I think you should take another one there.
Yeah.
Smaller one.
No, it's only 2.5 kilo. That's 3 kilos.
That's more than 3 kilos.
Oh yeah, a little, yeah. Very little more, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the.
Then those ones, you have to take a look also at those. You made that on zero, eh?
Yeah.
Yes.
I weighed the bucket empty first.
Yeah.
And adjusted. So this is 3 kilos.
Mm.
And
some sand.
Yeah, and some slime.
Yeah, you can see it, you know. It's it's kind of, it's even bubbling. You see it here, yeah.
You see the color of the fish,
yeah,
that
we have. Yeah, they're nice. Mm-hmm. Let's see, once we this one, it's already...
It's really scary to get them.
Yeah.
And they're moving a lot.
The head.
Yeah, but I don't want to squash them.
Yeah. That's already 12 1/4 kilo. And this is more than 3 kilos. I know, 1 1/4, sorry.
1 1/4.
1 1/2.
This 1 1/2.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't want to squash. It's going to affect
the
texture of the meat.
Mm-hmm. They have already 1 1/4, 2 1/4. Tenderly, it's 1 2 1/2. Mm, yeah, that's... Oh, that's 3.
Yeah, we have 1 over.
Ah, that's for me.
That's for Mama.
That's for Mama.
It's the smallest one.
For my alaga. Yes.
Anyway.
Okay.
So that's
put
for
there,
the weekend market tomorrow. But I'm not going to leave it there because a fish might jump out and get mixed up, and we're not exactly 3 kilos anymore, so we don't want to fool our clients.
Yes. Well, that's great.
Yeah.
So, this is now our cabbage. This will be for our market tomorrow. The petchay bagyo, I will only, they're very beautiful this time. There are no more aphids. Look at that. Mm-hmm. So I will not harvest so much because...
I think we need to harvest more, ma, because...
The others,
a lot of people confirmed...
Are coming?
Yeah, to come tomorrow.
Ah, yeah, okay, so...
So if we run out of other crops, at least we still have petchay.
Some petchays, yes.
Yeah, I think we have enough cabbage also, I think.
Mm.
I do not know.
Yeah, I think so.
There.
But I think we don't need to give too much, harvest too much cabbage. There's a petchay because petchay is like all-time favorite.
Yes,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And you're nice, huh? Yeah. They even eat it as parang as lettuce.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I will
they
harvest
eat
more.
It, yeah, harvest more petchay.
Okay.
Petchay,
yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it is nice. This one's so good.
We have here the... heart of the banana, which you can use this one also for vegetables. Normally, this is a thick layer, but we have to remove that.
Yeah, here are the layers.
Yes, we have to remove that because that's too hard to cook. Until the part, you remove that until the part that is already soft enough. This is ready for cooking.
Yeah.
But at the same time, what I remove from the heart of the banana is this one here. The flowers, it's like the banana blossom. You call
it's
this maybe
blossom.
The banana blossom.
Yeah.
This one here, I will put it in our dryer. Because you can use this one also for your adobo, which is very delicious for your sinigang.
Yeah.
Oh, many Filipinos would be very familiar with that. You can buy this one easily in Sari-Sari store. But
here
we will make it our own way.
Yeah, it's organic.
It's organic, and I will put that in a... I will not dry it under the sun, but in our dehydrating machine.
Yeah. This is one of the jalapeno peppers that we ratooned. It has a lot of fruits. You can see here. Buds developing non-stop, and we already have 3 formed jalapenos. So, 4. There's the 4th one. Wow, what ratooning can do to your plants. It rejuvenated. Very, very nice. Guduchi! What are you doing again inside? Guduchi. Bobby Boucher.
Mm-hmm.
Don't sleep on the job anymore. Or you will get honked on the nose. We are ready for tomorrow's mini weekend market. So these are the produce that we're going to take along later, and of course the 6 kilos
specially ordered tilapia for two of our clients.
What a beauty! So, apparently, so because I went outside earlier today, I asked around, the people who went through our farm and stole fighting cocks from our neighbor poisoned a lot of dogs. The path where they took to steal the chickens or the ducks. They use they said sodium to poison the dogs, and two dogs from our neighbors died with foamy mouths. I think that's from the poison. And we really hope that those people will get caught or brought to justice, and our hearts go out to the dogs that died in the process of their
must have been paid for.
Yeah, it's because when you kill animals or living creatures with the use of poison, most of the time it's a slow and painful death. So we surely hope that those people will get caught and brought to justice.
Yes.
Yeah. And what can you say about that, Papi Boucher?
Yes, good that you were asleep and sleeping on the job.
Yeah, it's a good thing.
Otherwise, you might have been poisoned too.
Yeah, it's a good thing you were sleeping, so we're not going to punish you.
No.
Yeah.